In this lesson, you will learn how to store and manipulate data using variables. Most computer programs require the use of variables to store data temporarily in memory. Variables can be thought of as containers that store numbers, text, which are also called strings, and logical data. Variables are automatically created for you when you use them in a statement. Let's look at an example to see how variables are used in a real program. Our macro is named main and contains statements that assign values to variables. Our first statement is a equals 5. The variable a is created and the value 5 is assigned to it. If we use the variable a later in the code, the value 5 will be put in its place. Variables may be used to calculate the value of other variables. The second statement is b equals 2 times a plus 4. The variable b is created and will be assigned the value on the right side of the equal sign. Just as in the Excel workbook environment, the order of operations is followed. 2 times the current value of a, which is 5, gives 10, and this is added to 4. The resulting value, 14, is assigned to b. The third statement is a equals a plus 1. This is nonsense algebraically, but it is very common to see statements like this in computer programming. The right side is evaluated first, and then the resulting value is assigned to the variable on the left side. A plus 1 is 6, and this value is assigned to A. The previous value of A is overwritten and gone forever. The fourth statement is B equals 2 times A plus 4. 2 times the current value of A, which is now 6, plus 4 gives 16, and this value is then stored in B. The previous value stored in B, which was 14, is overwritten and gone forever. The variables A and B store numbers. Strings, which are groups of one or more text characters, can be stored in variables too. The fifth statement, C equals, quote, hi all, exclamation, end quote, creates the variable C and stores the text hi all in that variable. The text you wish to store in a string variable must be written within quotation marks. You can stitch strings together using an ampersand, which is called the concatenate operator. The sixth statement is D equals C ampersand, quote, by exclamation, end quote. The characters by exclamation are stitched to the end of the string variable C, and the resulting string, hi all exclamation by exclamation, is stored in D. There are rules for naming variables. Variable names must begin with a letter. The rest of the variable name may contain only letters, numbers, and underscores. No other symbols are allowed. Variable names cannot be longer than 255 characters, and variable names cannot be one of the special reserved words like print or save. Although not mandatory, you should also get in the habit of making variable names short and descriptive. For example, say you want to store the mass of a ball in a variable. A couple of good choices for variable names would be mass or mball. Poorer choices of variable names would be the very long, the ball's mass, or the nondescriptive yyy or variable 3. In the example shown here, the program is designed to obtain data from the workbook environment, store that data in variables, and then the variables will be used to perform calculations. The result of those calculations will be output back to the workbook environment. In the worksheet named Sheet 1, I have typed 6 into cell B3, 7 into cell B4, and 2 into cell B5. I've already entered the VBA environment by typing Alt F11 and inserted a module by right-clicking under Modules, selecting Insert, and then Module. Within Module 1, I have written my code. Let's try to predict what this code will do. The first line is sub math fun. The name of our macro is math fun. Next, we select the worksheet named Sheet 1 using Sheets, Sheet 1 within quotations, dot select. Cell B3 is selected using Range, B3 within quotations, dot select. This means cell B3 on Sheet 1 is now the active cell. The value in the active cell is stored in the variable A using the statement A equals active cell dot value. The variable A now contains the number 6. Range B4.select makes B4 the new active cell, and B equals active cell dot value stores the value of the active cell in B. So the variable B now contains the number 7. Range B5.select makes B5 the new active cell, and C equals active cell dot value stores the value of the active cell in C. So the variable C now contains the number 2. Now that we have the data from the workbook stored in variables A, B, and C, we can use this data to perform calculations. The sum of A and B, which is 6 plus 7, or 13, is calculated, and that number is assigned to the variable SUMMY. SUMMY contains the number 13. Next, the value of B is divided by C. 7 divided by 2 is 3.5, and this number is assigned to the variable DIVI. Now that we have created two new variables and assigned numerical values to them, we output this data to the workbook. We are still in the worksheet named Sheet 1. Range A7.select moves the active cell to A7. Active cell.value equals SUMMY assigns the value in SUMMY, which is 13, to cell A7. Range A8.select moves the active cell to A8. Active cell.value equals DIVI assigns the value in DIVI, which is 3.5, to cell A8. And finally, N sub ends our macro. We can run our macro by clicking on the Run button at the top of the screen or striking the F5 key. We want to run the Math Fun macro. And notice that after we run our macro, two new values will appear in A7 and A8. If you change the value in cells B3, B4, or B5, and run the macro again, notice that new values will appear in cells A7 and A8. An important part of computer programming is making your programs as user-friendly as possible. In this example, we ran our macro by going into the VBA environment and clicking on the Run button. It would have been even more user-friendly if we could create a Run button on the worksheet itself instead of having to go into the VBA environment to run the macro. In the workbook environment, on the Developer ribbon, select Insert, then select Button under Form Controls. Click on the worksheet where you'd like the button to be located, and drag the mouse until the button is the desired size. An assigned macro box should appear. Click on the macro you want assigned to the Run button. In this case, Math Fun is the name of the macro. and click OK. You can change the text on the button by clicking on the button and making the changes directly. In this case, I'm going to call my button Run. When you're finished, you can click on the button to run the MathFun macro. Try changing the values in B3, B4, or B5. And clicking the Run button. You should see that the values in A7 and A8 get updated.